In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to quickly adjust your anchor point when using text animators. Let's go ahead and open up this text layer, and first I want to enable per character 3D. Then I'm going to add in a rotation text animator. Change the rotation value on our X rotation to 1, so we'll get 1 full rotation. Then I'm going to open up this range selector. And if you're not familiar with text animators, I do have a lot of tutorials that go over them. But for our purposes, just follow along. And if you use these three settings, this will get you by in most cases if you want to use text animators. First, let's change our ease low to 100%. Think of ease low as ease in. Then we're going to change our shape from square, which is the default, to ramp up. Now this is going to make our offset range negative 100% to 100%. Put a keyframe at the beginning of our animation, set our offset to negative 100%, go forward a little bit, and then increase our offset to 100%. Okay, and if we play that back, we can see how this is going to rotate from the bottom of our text. So whenever you add text animators, your anchor point defaults to the bottom of your text. So now what if I wanted this to rotate from the middle of my text? There's a really quick fix for that. If you open up more options, we're going to be focused on grouping alignment. Move the percentage of your Y value to a negative value, and as you can see, it moves these little X's up. Now they're kind of hard to see, so I'm going to push in. It's these little red X's. You can see that right there in the middle of my A. As I adjust the Y value of this grouping alignment, you can see it moving around. Now if you hold down Command or Control while scrubbing, you can get this value even more precise. Shift forward slash to fit our comp back to our viewer. And now if we watch it play back, we can see that it rotates from the middle of this text layer. So that's a really cool trick, and it's something that I use all the time, just adjust this grouping alignment. Now move the Y value of this grouping alignment to the top of our text layer. It's going to flip from the top of our text. Set it back to 0, it goes back to its default at the bottom. And then again, I'm going to just move this to the middle of our text here, and you'll see it animating from the middle. I like to name my animator, so I'm just going to name this in for now. And now let's add a few more text animators. I'm going to add in a position and an opacity. Change our opacity down to 0%. Change our position to 250. Whenever you're animating your text in, the values you set are going to be the starting values. So we want this text to have a value of 0 for the opacity to start off. So that's going to give us a fade in. And the position will be 250 pixels on the Y axis. So that will animate from the bottom to the top. And we still have our X rotation set at 1 time. So now we can see how that's going to animate in, coming from the bottom with an opacity value of 0%. So now we can change this X rotation value to negative 1 and you get a different look. And that's how you can quickly adjust the anchor point of a text animator using the grouping alignment Y value percentage.